Hello, everybody, and welcome back to World of Warships Legends. My name is Spartan Elite 43, and tonight we are back in the Arizona, and it's something that's been requested. Again, have you noticed the theme lately? I've been trying to get through all of the requested ships down in the comments, so if you guys want a specific ship, make sure you guys leave it down in the comments. It may not happen right away, but I do read, I do respond, and I do try to make a video for you guys for the ships that you guys want to see, because at the end of the day, without y'all, who am I? Just a goofy dude in the middle of nowhere playing video games. And where's the fun in that? So, without further ado, let's get in the best tier 5 battleship in my opinion. And that's not saying that the other tier 5 battleships aren't great. I just prefer the Arizona because it's so good. The guns are ridiculously punchy, ridiculously accurate, ridiculously long reload. Oh wait, that's not a good thing. But the ship is also extremely tanky, which is something that a lot of people just don't utilize properly. Now, in this particular game, we're not actually going to get to showcase the tankiness all that much. I mean, there'll be a couple of spots here and there, but the main thing to remember is that this thing has incredible belt armor. What is the belt armor? The belt armor is the thing at the waterline that protects you from the torpedoes, right? And it goes from roughly just in front of the front turret to roughly just behind the rear turret. It is responsible for that thing that we call the cheek, right? That is your belt. It is the thickest part of the armor on the ship, with the exception of the turret faces. Usually the turret faces of the guns are even thicker than the torpedo belt. Reason being, you don't want to lose a main gun on a battleship. That's kind of the whole purpose of the battleship, is to be able to shoot those big guns. If your big guns get destroyed, then they don't really have a purpose, right? Ask the Jean Bart. Anyway, with that being said, you want to utilize the armor belt when being engaged by anybody, which means a lot of time you actually don't want to be the first one to fire. A lot of times you want to get the people to shoot at you. Open up the angle a little bit, make it look like you're over angled, and then as they fire at you, you can already start turning in, and you close that angle, making it hit at a much steeper angle, so it's less likely to do damage. You'd be surprised how many auto bounces you'll get on armor piercing shells when people shoot at the belt armor thinking that they're going to get a big hit. Now this Gneisenau player, I know that it's a tier 6. He should, or they should, have a better understanding of what the Gneisenau is, but this guy just never gets it through his head that he's in a top tier battleship armed with torpedoes and does not have an advantage in a long range gunfight. But who am I to tell the enemy when they're making a mistake? Now, that being said, we are going to thoroughly dominate, and we are going to, as you guys already seen in the little Death Strike clips leading in, you guys have already seen what these guns are capable of. So you guys have seen that this is the one ship at tier 5 that I have gotten more 200,000 damage games in than any other tier 5 battleship, which is why I love this ship, man. It's so tanky, it's so good at surviving, unless a carrier decides it wants you, in which case you will almost certainly get screwed over by RNG every time and get given a permaflood every time you take a torpedo from an airdrop torpedo bomber. Just the way it is. I don't know why, it just seems to be the theory. But New Mexico are pushing over this way. We have the Gneisenau here, but this New Mexico is starting to turn away. I think that there's torpedoes on the way for him, but it doesn't really matter. As soon as he opens that turret or that cheek up, we get a shot right through the cheek of that bow side plating, and we get the Citadel. Not guarantee Citadel's there, but New Mexico is known for it. Most American battleships do have that vulnerability. If you catch them just in front of the front guns through the turret cheek with armor piercing, even at medium to long range, you'd be surprised what you can get away with. But here's where we're gonna have to like be a little bit more picky with where we aim. So we know that he's angled against us, so we aim high. We don't aim for the belt. Why? Because we know that the belt's good, right? We aim high. We aim for superstructure. Get some of those plunging fire shots. What's plunging fire? Well, as you're at range, the shells don't come in flat. They come in at an angle, folks, and that's the plunge that we're talking about. So plunging fire. The further away you are when you fire your guns, assuming that you have enough range to hit the target, the more of an angle that they're coming in at, which actually a lot of times means that they are coming in straight down or at a very steep angle, meaning you are likely to penetrate deck armor, which is usually a lot weaker than the belt armor of the ship. Okay, now here we get a good shot around the corner, and I'm not gonna lie, I thought I had this man, but unfortunately, just overestimated his speed by just a teeny little bit, and we overpinned his bow side plating. Why? Because instead of coming in at an angle where we're going through the cheek and into the citadel, we actually came in roughly at a 90 degree angle, and the shells just simply overpinned that much thinner armor at the front of the ship. But we are getting focused by an Atlanta. The enemy Gneisenau has chosen to run away, and if there's a single Gneisenau that I do not fear, it's one that is turning and running. I will never fear a Gneisenau that is running away in any ship. I'm sorry, it's just not a thing. But Atlanta gets a couple of hits on us, gets a fire, but I don't put the fire out. One, I have plenty of heals. I haven't taken very much damage, so I can heal all the fire damage back. Two, I also know that there are two destroyers left, and they were roughly in the right direction of heading in my direction, right? So the last thing I want, and I apologize, my phone keeps going off. I'll have to call my dad after this one's over. But yeah, it happens. But anyway, Fuso comes out. He's full broadside. I mean, do we need to say how this is bad? Now, Fuso has a raised citadel towards the back, so we want to actually hit further back on the Fuso to hit his citadel. And of course, we do manage to do just that. You want to hit just behind the superstructure and hit that like second turret there, which I guess would be turret 3 technically. But here we've got the rear turret of justice and truth armed and ready for the angled Atlanta. And if there's one time you ever want to see the broadside of Atlanta, it's when it's slightly angled in a battleship. And that is another death strike with a double citadel. You gotta love it. The rear turret of justice and truth once again coming through in the clutch, showcasing just how nasty this ship truly is. And this is where you want to be, right? Like, we are in a situation where we have absolutely been pushing the entire time. We have controlled every engagement that we've been in. We catch the Haguro over there for another citadel. And you can see I'm using the auto-aim, but I'm not just relying on the auto-aim. I'm adjusting the shot based on what he's doing on the mini-map, right? We can see the mini-map, so we know he's kind of reversing away from us. So I'm adjusting a little bit to try to finish him off. Unfortunately, we don't get it here. So this time we are just going to use, I think, the mini-map and then... or not mini-map, but the auto-aim, where you see me kind of like zoom in, zoom out, zoom in, zoom out until I get one that I agree with, and then I let it happen, and we finish him off. And then that just leaves the two destroyers and the enemy Gneisenau for the rest of this match. Now, like I said, Gneisenau here is actually within almost torp distance. He technically is in torp distance because I'm going towards him. We know that he has a 6 kilometer torp range, unless he has some sort of funky torp build range, which I know some people do run because it's sneaky, but generally speaking, 6 kilometer torp range on most German battleships, with the exception of the battle cruisers later on. But if you stay at least outside of 6 kilometers, you can avoid a lot of that torpedoes. But if you're going towards a target, just remember that those torpedoes are not going to travel 6 kilometers before they get to you, even if the target is beyond 6 kilometers. Okay, keep that in mind. But Gneisenau once again is just like, screw this, I'm out. I don't know if he just doesn't want to fight the Atlanta behind me or what, but this Atlanta's got to be having a blast. This guy was behind me the whole way, and we have just completely raffle stomped this side of the map. We're at 4 kills, we have 5 citadels, 1 dev strike, first blood. We've done our job here. The one thing I do regret in this is not staying close enough to the cap to help get the cap later on. But this Gneisenau, I mean, we're just going to showcase, like, I don't overmatch this Gneisenau, right? He has a 25 millimeter bow and stern plating. He does have actually a extended armor belt that goes all the way to the bow. I don't know if it extends all the way to the rear, but we know that that's even thicker than 25 mil. And so we don't have 15-inch guns or above. We can't overmatch him. He does have 15-inch guns on us, and he does overmatch our bow and stern. So again, we want to try to stay angled. Look at the angle that I'm at right now. Notice on the mini-map, or at the little ship icon, the little compass in the bottom center of the screen, that is showcasing where your guns are pointing, but also, if you use those little lines, you can try to put your ship in such a way that the shells coming in, and I like to use the dotted line for this, even though the dotted line is showcasing where... where your guns are trying to point, right? But if you use that to your advantage, you can get a very good 45 degrees to the enemy target that's shooting at you, right? Like, you can use those little lines to point at the enemy target and make sure that you're at least at 45 degrees or steeper than 45 degrees when the shells get to you, and you will bounce a lot more shells. Just a little tip and trick that I don't think I've ever told anybody, but it's something I do it out of habit. Like, it doesn't even cross my mind that I'm doing it as we pick up the Kraken with the fifth kill in this game, and 132,000 damage is a bottom tier ship, but didn't really feel like we were bottom tier because that Gneisenau was just like, I can't be bothered. But this is a perfect example. And the boss goes down. I wish I had just like driven straight into the cap, but again, I was wondering where the other destroyer was, and I didn't want to just drive into torpedoes, but yeah, unfortunately this match is over and we are done. So I'm just gonna go ahead and speed it up till we get to the end screen. That way you guys don't have to sit here and any longer than you absolutely have to. But let me know what you guys think of the Arizona. Did this video help you? Do you have any other ships that you guys want to see? Preferably tier 5 and up. I will try to go through the comments and pick ships that I see multiple people commenting on and say, hey, these are ships that I'm struggling with. Can you help us? I am always down to try to make those kind of videos for you guys. I'm not the best player, but I do have a good basic understanding of the game, and I can share what little knowledge I do have with the majority of you. So we pick up the top of the leaderboard, 2600 base XP, Kraken Unleashed, Dev Strike, High Cal, and First Blood medals. So if you like what I'm doing, punch the like button, leave a comment below, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and as always, I will see you in the next video.